Hello everybody, this is Sergey Baklakov, 25th of December 2019. In this video, just want to update about drone repair and to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. You guys are asking how is the drone repair went. I can say it went pretty good. You all remember how in the beginning of December I've got my drone freaked out and fallen down into the bottom of Fontanka River of St. Petersburg, Russia. Then I hired the diver for $200 and it got it off from the river, and immediately I delivered this to the repair service. The masters called me already in 3-4 days and said it's ready. I came and they said that actually I am lucky, because all they were need to do is just to dry it out in a dry bath. That's how they called it. And then just to lubricate, to clean it off, I mean all those microchips with a special chemicals, and it started to work again. Come on. Yeah, it's working. And I've paid another $200 for their work. And also they said that the battery that was there, it's exhausted, so it's considered like a lost. So in total, on these accidents, I've lost $500. And this is already went through the test. Actually, the video about Poltava battleship I filmed with already a repair drone, and that was a pretty nice test after repair, because it was a kind of aggressive environment for the drone back in that day, -5 degrees Celsius, and also I was in hundreds meters from the coast of Neva River, or maybe Finnish Bay, well, something in the border. It was an open area above the water, and the wind was pretty strong, but the drone has resisted this. It all kept the position pretty good. And by the way, Masters told me that drone never freaks out that day. The thing is, it's lost GPS signal, probably because in the city there's a lot of another devices that works on 2.4 gigahertz frequency, and it lost signal and automatically turns into so-called ATTI mode. In this mode, drone can't keep just one position because of no GPS. For this reason, once propellers are working, rolling, it just moves in direction of the winds. From the side, it may seem like it goes to where only the freaks out electronics of drone knows, but actually it goes together with the winds and direction of the winds. My neighbors drilling, the mofos. So that's it. But now I will know, and we'll just ready for this, and we'll be able to react so it never happened again. Well, I've got an experience. You know, everything when it's not killing us makes us stronger. And I want to say thanks so much to all of you who are supported and contributed to me with these accidents, with this misery. Special thanks to Deborah Parton, who contributed $1,000, and Ronald from Texas, who contributed $500, and all the rest people, almost 80 people. I sent you all guys the personal private videos thanking you. Well, I have a side channel where sometimes I just upload like my personal videos. They all are unlisted, only those can watch who have direct links. So I sent the links to all the contributors. Thanks so much. I actually raised more than I was really need for just a drone repair, but it has fixed another problems that I had. Well, I raised like $3,500, and you know, in October, I never told you because it was my stupid fault, but I've got my camera with my new lens stolen, my Panasonic GH4 and super wide angle lens that I've got just in April. Panasonic 818 millimeters got stolen because I forgot it's on the back seat of a taxi. I have found about it in an hour. I called to the taxi driver. He said there's no cameras. I addressed to the police. They contacted the passengers next after me. They said they never saw this on the back seat as well. And that's it. Once you can't track it, once they said they never saw this, there is no chance somehow to find it out. Well, nobody was going to torture them to make talking. Well, so I've got Panasonic GH5, which is one generation better than it was, and exactly the same super wide lens, Panasonic 818mm. In October and November, I had to use my old lens. So that's why in many videos from October and November, there was again that, you know, like a dirt in the center. It seemed like a smudge. Well, it's a scratch, but practically, just for a regular viewer, it looks like just a dirt. And many people told me about that. Well, but it was better than nothing. So now, got a new lens, so the extra money that I've got, it all will go for a channel. Well, already went, there's some money left, and also it all will go for making the new videos. Thanks so much for your contribution. Actually, you returned my belief in what I do in this stuff, because this year I've got such an you know, impression that mostly YouTube gone crazy. Now it goes such a trend that most of people, they need a trashy stuff. They don't need videos that make sense, quality made videos, informational videos. They need something light, something trashy, maybe abandoned places or a drunk or something to laugh about. But now you guys just returned my belief. Thanks so much. And for this reason, I want to wish you and myself a Merry Christmas, and I'm really looking for 2020, because I'm full of enthusiasm to keep making my stuff for you guys. So all the best to you in 2020, and my wish is to listen to your hearts and to do only what you really want to do, because that's what I'm gonna do. I will do what I really want to do. You know, stay tuned and keep watching. Comments, like, subscribe. Real Russia. No fake, no bullshit. See you. Mofo!